हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फिफ्थ यूनिट फ्रॉम आर सिलेबस। एक्चुअली फिफ्थ यूनिट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स। वी डिवाइड इनटू टू पार्ट्स। फर्स्ट पार्ट इज मैग्नेटिज्म एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट इज सुपर कंडक्टिविटी। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस यूनिट, दैट इज मैग्नेटिज्म। ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज मीन बाय मैग्नेटिज्म? All of you know that. What is mean by magnetism? It is the property, we can say magnetism is a property of certain substances to attract or repel the other objects. So we say magnetism is a force of attraction or repulsion. Now this force of attraction or repulsion is due to magnetic field. Okay, and magnetic field is caused by moving electrically charged particles. So electrical charged particles, when they are in motion, there is a generation or there is production of what? Magnetic field. So basic reason of generation of magnetic field is nothing but what? Moving charges, right? For example, here we can see when we pass electric current through the conductor, you can see here when we pass electric current through the conductor, we know that magnetic field is developed around it. We can take example of electromagnet. This is iron core, right? And wire is wound around it. When we pass current through this wire, the iron core get magnetized. It gets what? Magnetized. And magnetic field is developed around it. So here current is passing through the conductor, current is passing through this wire. Current is flowing through this conductor. That means actually electrons are in motion, right? And electrons are charged particle. So in this conductor or in this wire, charged particles are in motion and they produce magnetic field around it. So in this way, we can say that the motion of charged particles produce what? Magnetic field. This is basic reason. Now this property is actually inherent in some materials. For example, magnet. It shows magnetism. The magnet shows what? Magnetization property. Similarly, certain materials are there which show such a magnetic properties. Those are called as magnetic materials. Now, why these magnetic materials or why this magnet show magnetization? What is the reason of magnetization inside these materials? Or what is the cause of magnetization inside the material? That we are going to see now. So this is origin of magnetization in solid. Now we know a basic reason of generation of magnetization is motion of charged particles. Is it correct? So is there any motion of charged particles in solid? Suppose solid is having magnetization, that means is there any motion of charged particles inside the solid? Yes, of course. We know that solid is made up of number of atoms, and yes, means protons and neutrons, and electrons revolve around the nucleus in different orbits. Electrons revolve around itself also, right? So there is a motion of charged particle because electron is a charged particle. So there is motion of charged particle inside the atom, and that gives magnetic moment to an atom. So each atom, we can say each atom acts as a what? Tiny magnet. Each electron or each atom has a magnetic moment. It acts as a tiny magnet, and solid consists of million number of atoms in, and therefore total magnetization of solid is nothing but what? Sum of magnetic moments of its particles. So all of you got it? Magnetization in solid is due to what? Different motions of particles inside it. Different motions of charged particles inside it. It gives rise to magnetic moment to the solid. Now let us see in detail. In general, magnetic dipole moment of atom arises because of three sources. We said that key inside the solid atom has magnetic moment. So this magnetic moment which is possessed by an atom is due to three types of motions actually. Obviously, first is what? Orbital motion of electron. This is the first source, we can say. Electrons, we know that electrons revolve in different orbits around the nucleus. So this is a motion of charged particle, and you know that motion of charged particle produces magnetic field. It gives rise to magnetic moment, right? So here electrons are doing what? Orbital motion, and that's why they give rise to magnetic moment to an electron, or they give rise to magnetic moment to an atom. Okay, so orbital motion of electron contributes to what? Orbital magnetic moment of the electron. Now second reason is spin motion of electrons. As electron does orbital motion, it also does spin motion, means it also revolve around itself. That is called a spin motion of electrons. Now because of this motion, it also contributes to the magnetic moment of an atom. Right, and the third reason is nuclear spin. Nucleus also spin around itself, so it also contributes to the magnetic moment of an atom. But magnetic moment of the nucleus is very small. If we compare it with what magnetic moment is contributed by electron. So magnetic moment of nucleus is very small. So when we study magnetic properties of solids, the magnetic moment due to nuclear spin is neglected. So we can say that total magnetic moment or resultant magnetic moment of an electron is nothing but what? Orbital magnetic moment plus spin magnetic moment of electron. Yes, orbital magnetic moment is caused due to what? Orbital motion of electrons. And spin magnetic moment is caused due to what? Spin motion of electrons. And sum of these magnetic moments is nothing but what? Resultant magnetic moment of an electron. So smallest magnetic moment possessed by an electron is called as Bohr's magnetron. The smallest magnetic moment which is possessed by an electron due to its orbital and spin motion is called as Bohr's magnetron, and this is given by EH upon 4 pi m, where and this m is nothing but what? Mass of electron. So every electron, or we can say each atom inside the solid possesses magnetic moment. So total magnetic moment of the solid is nothing but what? Sum of magnetic moments of its particles. So this is all about origin of magnetization. So did you understand what is the reason of magnetization in solid? It is the orbital and spin motion of electrons. The question, if you see here, based on it is explain origin of magnetism. So this is a simple question for 4 marks. Okay, so this is all about origin of magnetization in solid. In the next lecture we are going to study some parameters related to magnetic field.